Students, today we have to discuss microwave spectroscopy. This type of spectroscopy is actually dealing with the rotation of molecules. And as we know, in electromagnetic spectrum, we have different regions. And one of the regions is microwave region. It starts from 10 to 12 hertz, and if you count in meters, it will be from 1 centimeter to 100 micrometer. The molecules which are active in this region, they must have molecules must have permanent electric dipole moment. So the main condition for this type of spectroscopy is the molecules which you are going to study in this spectroscopy, they must have permanent electric dipole moment. So they will be active in this type of spectroscopy. The example for permanent molecules having permanent electric dipole moment, one of the example is HCl. Here you have permanent negative charge and permanent positive charge, and this molecule has permanent electric dipole moment. So it will be active under while dealing with this type of microwave spectroscopy. And the example for those molecules which are inactive in this spectroscopy, for this case, you have molecules of H2 and Cl2. These type of molecules are inactive in microwave spectroscopy. So orientation of molecule and its corresponding dipole moment is quite important to generate the signal. Okay, for example, we have HCl, and I will show you this is its positive and this is negative. And if I show this part is positive and this is negative, then we have different types of rotations to get a signal like wave. Suppose you have in this direction positive over here and negative here. If you rotate in this way, positive will come over here, negative here, and further rotation will give you this negative in the upper side and positive, and further rotation will give you here is negative, here is positive, and then further rotation will give you this positive and this negative, and further it will be like this, and it will repeat. And if you go for the direction of dipole moment, and we know that dipole moment is like this, it is actually directed towards the more electronegative atom. So in here its direction will be like this. Here this, in this case like this. For this particular case, you have this kind of direction, and then here, and finally you have this type of direction. If you want signal, this negative here is zero, here is negative, but here is positive. In this case, negative is below zero, so this will be the spot, and it's parallel and it's upper, okay, and again parallel, again upper, again parallel. Now you can generate like this. So this is your electromagnetic wave. But if this molecule is, because this molecule is have a permanent dipole moment, so this type of interaction of light will give you a rotational spectrum. And here, if you have two different molecules with different permanent dipole moments, they will give you different rotational spectrum. Okay, now to study the rotation of molecules, we have to deal with I. What is I? I is actually moment of inertia. Okay, to study the rotational spectra or microwave spectroscopy, we must know the concept of moment of inertia. And we know that for a particular body, mass m, I is equal to m r square. R is actually here the distance from it is actually the distance. And because we have to study a molecular spectroscopy, and we are particularly dealing with the rotational spectroscopy, and we consider that the diatomic, we are dealing with diatomic molecules, and we consider it, the bond between them is like hard bar or solid bar. Solid bar. Suppose this is your molecule A and this is B. A and B. And the distance between these, and you call it or not. And here is the center of mass. This is called center of mass. When you have two bodies, they are actually attached with each other, then there will be, then the whole mass will occupy or will direct it towards a center that is called center of mass. Okay, and if this body B is your 2, you can call it atom 2, and this is atom 1, and the distance from this to center of mass is R1, and its distance is R2. So R0 will be equal to R1 plus R2, and if you include the mass of that body, that will be equal to M1 R1 is equal to M2 R2. And if you, because we will actually find the moment in searching or in pursuing the concept of moment of inertia, so moment of inertia for a system having two bodies will be M1 R2 square plus M2 R2 square. After solving this equation, we have the final result is I mu R0 square. What is mu? This mu is called reduced mass. What does it mean? Reduced mass. Whenever you have one body system, a system having one body, then you will have to deal with the mass of that body, that one body. If you have a system wherein you have two bodies attaching with each other, then you will not go for simple mass or individual mass of each and every body, but you will have to find the reduced mass, meaning the body, the mass, the effective mass that wherein both masses are going to influence. So you will find the reduced mass. And how will you find this reduced mass? And as you know, I is equal to mu R0 square. This is actually because you are dealing with two bodies and they are connected like this, A and B. This R0 is the distance between, it is called internuclear distance or interatomic distance as well. And for more explanation, it will be equal to bar length. And I is the moment of inertia, meaning the reduced mass. You will find mu M1. M2 divided by M1 plus M2. Here is you have atomic mass of hydrogen, meaning atomic mass of hydrogen is equal to 1.67 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. Okay, you have mass of one body, mass of other atom, and then you will have to add both mass, and finally you will have to multiply with this value, and you will come up with the reduced mass. Suppose you want to find the reduced mass of HCl. Okay, we know the mass of hydrogen, relative atomic mass, relative mass of hydrogen is 1.008. Okay, and for Cl you have 30.55. Okay, and you want to find the reduced mass a system having hydrogen and chloride. So by applying this equation, you have mass of HCl is equal to hydrogen 1.008 multiplied by mass of hydrogen, atomic mass of relative atomic absolute atomic mass, that is 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. And then you have 35.5 multiplied by 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. Okay, in below in denominator 08 multiplied by 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg plus 35.5 multiplied by 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. In further, in next step, you have 1.008 35.5. Here you have 1.008 plus 35.5. Here you have 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg raised to power 2, because you are multiplying this one with this one. And below you have the common factor, that will be equal to 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. And now you have this value will be considered this one, and you have 1.008 35.5 divided by 1.008 plus 30.5 and 1.67 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. This equation, this part is similar to that of this part, because here you have M1, this is your M2, this is your M1, M2, and this is your absolute atomic mass of mass of one atom of hydrogen. In this way, you can find the value of reduced mass, and if you are given the value of inertia, you will easily find the value for if you are given with value of mu HCl, any value, and moment of inertia, any value, then you will find the value of the bond distance or the interatomic distance between H and Cl. That will be equal to, if you know I is equal to mu R naught square, this will be equal to I over mu and or I over mu under root. In this way you can find the value of bond distance. Okay, now if we have I the moment of inertia, then to study the microwave spectroscopy, you will have different types of molecules. On the basis of inertia, we have three different types of inertia for diatomic molecule, which we will consider the having molecule having a bond like rigid bar. Okay, so we can call it diatomic rigid molecule. So diatomic rigid molecule, rigid molecule, because we are considering that the bond is like rigid bar. Okay, so moment of inertia, because we are dealing with space, a three dimensional, the moment of inertia along x-axis or along the bond axis is called Ia. Suppose this is x-axis here, this is your z-axis, and this is your y-axis, and this will be called Ib, and this will be called Ic. Okay, Ia, what is Ia? How will you write I and then you have to write capital A in subscript. This is actually the moment of inertia, the moment of inertia when rotation is about is along bond axis. Okay, secondly you have IB, the moment of inertia when rotation is about or rotation is in the plane of paper. In the plane of paper. Okay. And third one is IC, the moment of inertia when rotation is at right angle to the paper. Okay. In that case, you have three different values for inertia. On the basis of the relative values or the difference in the values of inertia, we have classified molecules in four types. What is actually the moment of inertia along bond axis? Suppose this is your HCl molecule. Okay, HCl. This is your HCl molecule. Like this. Suppose this red cap is your H and this red tip is your Cl. Just for example. So, this is its bond axis. The rotation about bond axis like this. Mean this. This rotation along bond axis is called IA. Okay, and this rotation like this, this rotation means you are going to rotate like this. This is your IB. Okay, and if you are rotating like this, this is the center of mass. Okay, then you will rotate like this. This is, this rotation is along its bond axis and this rotation is IB in the plane of paper, and this rotation mean like this is IC. So while rotating any molecule in these three rotations, three ways, then we will have to classify, or we have a classification of molecules on the basis of different values of moment of inertia. We have classified the molecule in four different types. What are these molecules? We have four different types. One of them is linear molecule. Other one is asymmetric tops. Next one is symmetric tops. And finally, we have spherical tops. Okay? In case of spherical tops, we have all three values of inertia are equal to each other. For these spherical tops, we have example like CH4, made in this way. Okay? Equal bonds and all sides are equal. So, the all three values of inertia are equal.
For asymmetric tops, we have all three values are unequal.
For asymmetric tops, all values are unequal, and the example for this is water like this.
Okay. For now, we are left with two different types, symmetric tops and linear top, linear molecule. For linear molecules, we have IB, we have IC, and these two are equal, like this. Suppose this is your linear molecule, IB is like this. Its moment of inertia, the value of moment of inertia in this rotation and in this rotation are equal. This rotation and this rotation, the moment of inertia, the values of moment of inertia are equal. Whereas IA is equal to 0. 0 means it's too small. The value along the axis, along the bond axis for linear molecule is nearly zero, mean very small. Like if this the energy along this part is very small, so it will be considered zero. So this example is like HCl or OCS. Okay, this is oxygen, carbon and sulfide. Okay, like this molecule. Now finally we have symmetric tops. Okay, in symmetric tops we have IA, IB is equal to IC. Meaning into the paper and out of plane of paper, the inertia of molecule which come under the category of symmetric tops, they have the values of moment of inertia into the plane of paper and out of the plane of paper, and to end rotation, they have similar values. But the difference is with IA. The value of IA is in fact different from these two values. These two values are usually equal, whereas the value of moment of inertia along bond axis are different. Here we have two different ways, and this is also not equal to zero. Meaning it will not too small value, it has some values, but the value of this inertia along bond axis will not equal to these two. Then we have two different ways to deal with symmetric tops. Either IB equal to IC is greater than A, or IB is equal to IC but these two values are less than IA. Okay, we have two different classifications. If it is not equal to 0, mean it has some value but this value is not equal to these two, then we have two chances. Either it has lesser value than these two or greater value. If it has lesser value, then it is called prolate. And if it has greater value, it has oblate. Okay? Prolate and oblate. Now I will explain what are actually oblate and prolate. Okay? Now here we have symmetric tops. For symmetric tops, IB is equal to IC but not equal to IA, and IA is not equal to 0. Then we have further two classifications. In one case you have I B minimal shear on into the plane and out of the plane are equal, but they are greater than I A. And other part is I B I C are lesser than I A. I said this is called prolate, and this type of molecule are called oblate. From these two words, prolate means elongated, and oblate means flat. Means to flat. These are actually ellipse. You know ellipse? Like this. These are ellipse. Okay? In case of prolate, suppose as it is elongated like this, and its axis is this bond axis, and you have prolate like this. Okay? And its inertia is IA. Whereas in this case you have molecule like this ellipse, but here is the axis and here is your IA. Okay. In which case the value of inertia is greater between these two values? In that case, the value of inertia is greater along bond axis, so this is called flattened or oblate. Whereas in this case, this value is smaller, it is called prolate. The example for elongated or molecules having prolate like shape is CH3F, like this. This is your CH, and here you have F. But the example for this is boron chloride, its structure like B, Cl, Cl, and Cl. Now this is actually like its center, like this, whereas in this case you have this type of molecule and here you have white. In this case here you have elliptical but greater. So now, till now you have studied four different concepts. One of them is microwave spectroscopy is actually dealing with the rotation of molecules. For particular rotation, the molecules must have permanent dipole moment. If they have the permanent dipole moment, then we have to deal with the concept of inertia, and we have to find the value of inertia. If you have values for inertia, then you will have to find the values along all three axes, and you have to compare, and then you will be able to classify the molecules in four different types: symmetric tops, asymmetric tops, linear molecules, and then spherical tops. Okay.